something to watch, wondering. I'm trying to decide if we need to find this dropdown more.
Awesome. So I want to put a link to your site, but I know that is.
And then do you hyperlink sentences in the first?
I can.
Okay.
Yep.
For sure. Okay. Because once we start, we're getting this book up on Amazon right now.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And then we'll also have some stuff on
you
the
can
site
definitely
there.
Do that in the WordPress. You can just hyperlink.
Right. Okay. As a note, some sites don't let you.
It's okay.
Link,
yeah.
So.
We want to drive traffic back and forth.
Right.
So
yeah.
That's sort of the goal.
Okay. Cool. And then, so for the Google Plus,
do you know how to do that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
okay.
Great.
Yeah.
So do you have, so I know
you like
you're really
this, right?
Limited to 9 people, unless you have, only 9 people.
Well,
I know, like, mm-hmm. Obama doing, mm-hmm. for example, like, I don't dial in,
yeah.
You know, but...
I'll have our SEO people.
Okay. Yeah, because otherwise it's, like, I think mm-hmm. that's 9 people.
They can do it, and so we'll organize that, sort of, like, in a calendar, too.
Okay. Yeah, so it'd be perfect, like, to line some up for January.
Yep.
We'll do them in college, and...
That would be great.
Yeah, we're still working on it.
Okay, cool.
I'm like four beyond that. I started at the bottom too.
That's the first one. At the bottom.
Yeah. I'm like four out from there.
Oh, okay.
I can't believe. So I like on Friday was like looking at Storm Post, the Pulse Point documents. Mm-hmm. I couldn't believe they would name their parameters ARG1, ARG2, ARG3. So like the whole day I was like, oh, I'll just pass it in a string. But no, it's actually
one?
Yes.
As an argument one?
Yeah, that's how you pass parameters in to their system.
It doesn't look like they developed their system.
It
looks like they acquired system that was done before and they never really understood it.
Check out their example. Like that ARG1, ARG2. It's an array.
Dear Lord.
It's like, no, really?
Well, at least the call is do import and send from template. It's really easy to figure what do we do, right?
Yes, exactly.
ARG1 equals 1, ARG2 equals 2.
That is...
Well, I like that R3 reminds me of old TXT files I used to generate. I like that. I like using pipe for stuff. It's much makes much more sense for me than XML.
That's actually how they do all their imports of table columns. You import it exactly like that.
The weird thing is that they have an XML with lines like this, right?
Yeah.
They don't have, like, name, last name, email. They have one beta point in the XML that has the entire line. You're not really embracing XML there. But I like ARG1, 2, 3. I think we should do the same. As in par. As in parameter. Part 1, part 2.
Ryan, it's Jess. All right, how are you? Great. Do you want to
It wouldn't even find the food. And then other times it would pull the food up, and I would go through the painstaking process of selecting all of the ones that I wanted, and I'd do the whole thing, and then I'd say, send the report to my email address. It's job number 14,
15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. I bet you they didn't have the emails. I can remember what.
Yeah, I looked up the URLs and it doesn't work.
Really?
Yep.
Okay, give me 10 minutos.
Okay, which is precious.
I know, especially with all the alcohol. So definitely reference that. Say, hey, you know, we're curious how much you well, we were looking at a list of items, and then they were graduating.
say.
Thank you. Thank you. How's it look?
Yeah, where are you guys going? Like just right out front? I'm like, well, I still have my phone back. So Eric is only wanting to use that for picture?
Okay, people will get pictures on the back spot.
Okay, okay. Okay.
You don't have pictures anymore.
I'll let you guys have that. What's that? That's good. They don't have that.
Hi,
lunch? I have lunch.
The pacifier, is that for your dessert?
Yeah, I just have my nap.
That's your nap? Oh, okay.
Okay, so it wasn't like you got like an H-1B figure or anything, you were already here when you came to
When I first came to the U.S., I was a J-1, actually.
Oh, okay.
And then I got an H-1B, the company Pasadena was on.
Oh, okay. Transferred to Demand. Cool. All right, great. Yeah, I'm just, that's great, because you have certainly plenty of years of experience, so I just want to be able to bring that up for your detail.
Oh, cool.
Thank you.
sure you're dying to get your phone.
I would like it back.
Yeah.
Because I haven't been able to do it in so many years.
Oh, yeah.
But,
that's right. You did.
Yeah.
So, just to mention, like, you chose Cody before, and then Jeremy, and then Mike's
okay.
And when you're talking about those, which ones they are, the slideshows that we were going to send out, the professional photographer, the one that you were working on the contact for, so that we, which ones are those?
But with the contributors, we always use their bylines. So there's no time that the articles are used without their attribution as part of it. So
exactly.
It shouldn't have that.
So there's questions like that about it, and then there's just, there's also things where,
should say, yeah, whether it should have something, a clause in there at that part that it's like based on the quality of the images, not based on whether we use them or not.
Exactly.
If the images are deemed usable quality, they will get paid.
Yeah, exactly.
So have you gotten those notes back to Martin?
So no, I've
got to
take them up and
get them
back to Martin.
Okay.
And then we'll take them from there to what he says.
Okay.
I'm going to be curious to see what he's talking
about. Great.
Definitely.
Thank you.
Tracy, it's Kate Ryan. Hey, good. How are you doing? Is this a good time? Awesome. And it's pretty basic makeup, too. It's not anything crazy. Yeah. Right. Because the how to add fullness to hair is, I mean, for the 10 simple style, yeah, for the how to add fullness to hair, it just seems like some of this we'll have to really order it correctly too, to like the powders and how we're actually going to show some of this stuff. I see what you're saying. I mean, if we pick 10, and then it could be like, you know, do another, like, 10 how to add fullness to fine hair. Because I'm just trying to think, this is a lot of different things, too. And how will we show, you know, the dry shampoo and the fiber powders to make each one look a little different? Visually, how do you think we can... Like some of them might be so simple that it's just one. It's one step. Right. Right, right. Now I understand that. Right, exactly. I mean, right, I think that would probably be great too, because when I just think about learning when you watch. When I personally Google, like, how to French braid my bangs, or whatever, I like step-by-steps. And I think that would probably be easiest for our users if we did that, if we broke it down like that. Like, we did five and broke it down step-by-step. I think would probably be the best, if that's doable within, for you guys to come up with ones that we can do that with. You know, how to show it, are we going to show it kind of in a way that, like, you know, let's just say for instance, like, blow dry your hair in the opposite direction of growth, are we going to, illustrate, I'm trying to decide what would be most, like, visually pleasing to show what the hair looks like after you blow dry your hair in the opposite direction, or are we going to show kind of how that looks, like, to do that Right, no, definitely not. Yeah, right.
No, not at all. No.
I would just do a Google search. Right. Okay, yeah. I think it's just trying to get them to look different enough. Like, I guess that's just my question. Is like, so if I think that's a great idea, but in like the sort of blowing
what's your
hair down in the direction of growth. Okay.
Do you have a Whole Foods by you? Yeah, I think that's great. Right. Exactly, right. That's exactly how I'm seeing it. Budget, what that was going to say, so that would up the budget by, what is it? Yeah, right. So what is that off the budget? Right, no, you didn't. And so what is your product? Did you send a link with him? Like a piece of, did you send me a link of his images? I don't know. Anything on it? Oh, so no big deal. I'll talk about it. Yeah.
So, let me just check this. I better check this out. Thank you.
know. I feel like any day I have a college teacher or something. Like, not you, but me, too, in that same way. How are you?
I'm doing well. Finally, we get to chat.
You're a very busy man. Less America. You deserve a medal. You want a massage? And I'm not sure, whatever you want. What? Oh my god. All right. Do you have any idea what we're talking about? Because I do. I do. I don't know if that makes sense. Okay. So let's see. I've known Suzanne for probably, I don't know, 8 years? Yes. I know. Who doesn't love her? The best. So, she and I work for Lipstrom, as you know, and we've talked a lot about a lot of things in the past few years about how she could possibly be involved. And as it turns out, we are creating a new network of, I like to say, influencers or expert bloggers who would create content that is brand new, that would live on Lipstrom. And yeah, so there's that. And she had talked to me a little bit about, I know that she has a site and she does some writing and she does some related stuff and that kind of thing. But I think that she could have a great voice here on Lipstrom. We're sort of doing, we have a bunch of different categories that the blogs would fall under. So there's food, fitness, health, weight loss, lifestyle, and moms and family. And I feel like she would be a great person to have under the health category, but that doesn't make her exclusively writing only health content. She could write something about any of those topics or categories I just said, and we could tag the blog that way so that people who necessarily wouldn't be reading health blogs might get a view of something that she's saying. Like, I know that she's doing her daily meditations on Facebook, and she's, you know, she's more than just a doctor. And whether the blog, we're asking people to do a minimum of 2 blog posts per month, whether it's written or short video, because she's good with, she's great with either, I would figure. And yeah, we have close to 30 million uniques per month, and I think that's a really low guesstimate. That's sort of what Comscore says, but we think it's closer to 40 million. We have 2.5 million people that receive our newsletters every week. And you know, it's like that time of year where in December, January, our traffic doubles for quite a while. And I'm sure that once that happens, we'll be able to have even more uniques per month moving forward, just as people get into the new year and making resolutions. And then I think it's just interesting how much our site has grown. Once people start coming to the site and receiving newsletters, they usually stay. It's a content for distribution deal, so it would just be about helping her build her brand. And because she has such a good name, and she's a doctor, and she has a good voice, it would be helping us build our brand too by having such a quality person write for us. I'm gonna send you over the contract just so you can see it. So she and I talked about this. Oh my god, we decided to have a meeting at Everybody's a while ago, which was very fun. Send you a link to my blog so you can sort of get an idea of what her bio page would look like.
we, like I said, it's too close to home. We would obviously, if she had things going on, you know, it's sort of like cross-dimensional, we would definitely be, you know, pumping this out on social media and newsletters at the Fed. And we'd even be interested in doing like a Google Plus hangout chat with her, if that's something that she's interested in doing. So, I mean, she's just so awesome. I feel like she is a great voice for our women readers. Have a great Thanksgiving. Okay, I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.